anyway, what is your question, or what you are asking?
I've known you so long, but I've had how many years to ask the questions, but Leo hasn't, you know, so probably more questions.
Yeah, you ask a lot. I explained you many things.
Right, I mean, I've known you for so long.
Some of the things that you are weak, and I think I wrote for you, was about the four basic songs in flamenco.
Right, the four basic songs.
This is important to know. I mean, if you sometimes are going to teach and you have to teach theory about flamenco, this is important than the people know, because this is, and I did this because so many people ask me, even in the university, when I teach, okay, but where come from this song or this piece, or how this work? And of course, you have to explain. Sometimes I look, if you want, you have to study from the beginning, you have to study from where, and of course you have to study about the history, and they say, many people don't want that.
That's right.
Many people don't want, they even don't want theory. Then come to class and say, I want to learn this song, for example, this piece. And you say, okay, look, first you have to do, no, yeah, no, but the theory, I like to play. You know, people do things like that, you know. But the flamenco, festival, one thing important is to know where I come from. And you have the first book.
Right.
My first book is very small history about that, where flamenco come from. Then it's from the, or the culture that passed through Spain through the century. But century and century back, you know, you don't have interest in Godo, Visigodo, Certa, Certibero, Roman, Arabic, Jewish, Gypsy, all this kind, we have all those kind reminiscence in the flamenco, toda cosa, all those kind of things. And of course, everybody aports something. You know, the more modern one that you can consider was the Arabic, that means a lot of influence in flamenco, how you know.
Sí.
Also, the Jewish have a lot of influence in the flamenco through the song of the synagogue, where the rabbi sing in the synagogue. This is many of the flamenco things coming from there, from this kind of song. And this is very important. This is just a little bit, you see. This is very important. Later, the last one, of course, the Arabic, more than anyone, but later also is many influences from different things. One of them is the last one was the Gypsy. The Gypsy, some people say, okay, Gypsy, but what is Gypsy? And many people, they don't know either what Gypsy is. Also, I explain this in this book. I don't know if you have this book.
The basic techniques?
Basic techniques.
Yeah, he's got it.
I know that many people even don't read the beginning. They don't care about it. Then went directly to the pieces.
Okay,
or the technique, right? People say, oh, the technique, what are you? And the pieces. And they don't care about some of the explanation, you know. Even in my classes, many people come and say, oh, yeah, I know that rajeado is like that, blah, 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 blah. Say, okay, but where flamenco come from? I don't know. They don't know, feel like that. You know?
Right.
It's very important to know. And in this book, I explain this about what flamenco is, and also where the flamenco word come from, because they don't know either. But it's in this book also, where the flamenco come from, the word. But not the word come from the Arabic. The Arabic.
Ah, sí.
The Arabic people, you know what Arabic, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
The Arabic was expelled from Spain when the Catholic queen, the Catholic king and queen, came in the Dominion, when they took over Spain. And the Arabic, many of them, then hide in the country because they don't want God. It was from Spain already, they were born over there. But, you know, was different Catholic, different religion, different things. And, because then was persecuted, or we was persecuted, they call in Arabic, you call Felak Menkun. Felak Menkun, even I have it, the word written in Arabic.
Wow.
In English, in Spanish, and in Arabic, I have it. Pelak Menkung was being persecuted, you know, this is what I mean, persecuted.
Uh-huh.
You know, they are
persecuted people because they were like wanderers.
Right, but then called the persecuted
Opre Roma.
People, same thing happened later with the gypsy, the same thing with the Arab, it was first, you know, when they persecuted. And if you see in the book, you can see all those kind of things. They were persecuted. And they talked with another, you know. What do you know? I am Pelak Menkung. Pelak Menkung. Yo soy uno de los árabes perseguidos. Es la palabra Pelak Menkung. But this war, they people living with the, also with some Catholic, I mean, Christian people. And, you know, then also hiding different things. And then they start to talk about this. And of course, the Christian people also learn this word, and then in Andalusia, but Andalusia is like Puerto Rico and like South America, and they don't pronounce good in Spanish. They pronounce very bad in Spanish. In Andalusia, I am from Andalusia. For example, you know how you say Madrid? How you say
Madrid?
Madrid.
Uh-huh.
You forget to put the D in the
end. Right.
This is
that's
the thing.
Right,
I don't do it. I say Madrid.
Exactly.
Because we don't pronounce it correctly like Castilian. In this case, instead of Pelak Menkung, start to horrible, they start to make it wrong pronunciation. Pelak Menkung Flamenco, and this comes the word Flamenco. From Pelak Menkung. Later, the Gypsy. Gypsy come from Indian. The Gypsy people are from India, it's not Gypsy, they are Indian. From century and century ago, then they had to escape from India, many big group, like from Cuba, many people escaped when they
right.
For some reason, many people escaped from Russia. Took more than 300 years, because they escaped from Russia, from India in the 11th century. And then came to Spain, and then arrived over there, I think it was in the 14th or 15th century. 3 centuries, almost 4 centuries after the then war. And this time, then was all around the different world, then was in many different places. You know, then came a group over here, another group over there. You know, when they came to Spain, then came from Egypt. Was many Egyptian Egypt, was many Egyptian, many different, like peninsula, Balkanica, many, many. But when they came from to Spain, they came directly from Egypt, Egypto.
Uh-huh.
Now, Egypt, you know, in Spanish, is Egipto. The people, you are from Puerto Rico, what are you? You are Puerto Rican, no?
Exacto.
I am from Córdoba, yo soy Cordobés. Okay, the people from Egypt, in Spanish, of course, son from Egipto, son egistanos. Egipto, egistano.
Right.
Yo soy egistano. Entonces, the Hispanic people from Spain, they believe that these people was from there. You know, because they came directly from there. And they start to say, oh, they are egistano, but in Andalusia, they say that in Puerto Rico, they mispronounce the word. And if they don't say, they are egistano, they start to say, oh, yeah, it's egistano, they say, en gitano. We mean gypsy, when you translate, it means gitano. Gitano is the word, but then usually lo gitano, that it means gypsy in English. But the meaning was ep gitano, because they believe that they coming from Egypt. And still like that, you know, and everywhere in the world now, the gypsy because it's gitano. I mean, this is important, the history. And the gitano was the last one that bring a lot influence in the flamenco. And many of the things, the influences that they brought, you see, it's like when you hear many flamenco people sing, for example, in the song, you not more than in the music, in the song you see people singing, and you see the influence, the Arabic, you see influence for the Oriental country, Orientale, sí. You know, and all those kind of things because the gypsy brought those kind of things, you know, but the flamenco already existed in Andalusia. Now the people in our day, they believe that the Andalusia, I mean the gypsy, invented the flamenco. they believe it's all just flamenco gypsy. No, the flamenco, the gypsy don't invent it. The flamenco, the gypsy adopt very well what they find in Andalusia and then add the influence of the song and then bring from century ago. No, from then from Indian, Egypt, and all those kind of things, and then bring all those kind of influence. In this case, flamenco, yeah, people say it's gypsy, but no, flamenco is Andalusia. Even it had a gypsy influence. This is very close history about the
thing.
Now, when we talk about the basic form, in flamenco you have many forms. I don't know if you understand many of them, you know. Bulería, sevillana, alegría, tango, siguirilla, soleare, toná, taranta, taranto, malagueña, murciana, cartagenera, esos son many different songs. Colombiana, guajira,
or
the kind of, okay. Those songs are not part of the flamenco, then are at later. Colombiana, guajira, or those kind of things, what can the people call in Spain in our day, then call in Spanish, cantes de ida y vuelta.
Ah, sí, cantes.
Son, who, how do you say in English? Go and back.
Back.
Is the form a song from go and back.
Oh.
Meaning that, for example, many people went to Cuba and then bring our style. But then also have the style over there that they sing it by guajiro. Guajiro is campesino, you know that? Campesino. And then hear those kind of song over there and then sing it, our song with their rhythm over there. You know, and a little bit miss, and you know, and miss in between. And when they come back to Spain, come all completely different, you know. And anyway, they all guajira, you know, and they start to call the guajira colombiana, was the same thing. People don't go to Colombia back and forth, you know.
Uh-huh.
And this is how those influences came, a little influence from there. Now, the rhythms in flamenco and almost in everything, you know from where come from? The rhythms. You don't know either?
No.
From the black people.
Africa.
From Africa. The reason of that in the flamenco, and the way that they put, of course, the rhythm coming from music, from a question, but then in Spain, when Cristóbal Colón came to America, later they started to send many different barcos, many boats, they sent over here to discover different new land, new places. And all those bones, the boat come from Seville. This is why Seville has so influence, so strong influence in flamenco.
Sí.
They came from Seville. But at this time, you have the slave. This time the slave, what the people don't rem the boat and things like that. And those slaves, the majority, of course, was black people from Africa. They had to stop in Seville to take the bow, make the preparation, this and later. Same. Those people in Seville, they make all the arrangement and join and party and everything, when they wait in the port and everything with the bongo and the rhythm and the music. And those kind of rhythm and music is what stay over there.
Uh-huh,
you know what I mean?
Right.
And this is why later they hear so many syncopations, so many things like that, and they learning from there. And this case, all this kind of thing come from them. Anyway, even in Africa, centuries ago, in the way that they communicate with the drum, you know? The drum was like system of Morse. And they listen and they answer. In this case, the rhythm, believe, come from all the kind of thing. The basic four song is because the first song that ever came from the gypsy, they called toná. Toná means a song, you know? Oh, una toná, como un tono, una toná. And this coming from song, but they call in Spanish toná, una toná. The toná was the first song that they do without a company of guitar or anything. It was no guitar, nothing. It was just the boy. And this was only one, and the people sing this, and they have a beautiful influence, you know, between Arab and between Jew, and the people start to listen, oh my God, how beautiful is that, why is this? And this was the person and that. From there, they start to doing different tonight, you know, if you hear about this kind of thing. Guantanamo called Carcelera.
Carcelera, I never heard that one.
No, oh my God. It's another Tonadan called Martinete.
Martinete.
Tampoco, you no, don't know about sir. That? Okay, this is very deep because it's very a lot before the really flamenco than you know.
Wow.
Before that. Was another one than called was three and lo que le llaman Tona Grande, the first one, the original. Okay, Carcelera mean the gypsy in Spain was like the black and the beginning over here. They don't have a good life because the people don't want to be with them. You know, and they don't give any job, they don't have any work. And the poor people, the people say, oh, the gypsy was very bad. No, the gypsy was not bad, was they don't have a way to survive because they don't have any job, they don't have anything. And then have to steal sometimes, but to steal minor. You know, then go maybe where they make him country where they melon, watermelon, still like that. They go and steer there and then go to another place and olive in space, a lot olive in Andalusia. Oh. And then take olive and go to some house in the ranch and go in the little place and steer one chicken, something like that. Thing to give food to the children. Was not because they want to be bad people, because they don't have another way to do it. Because the people hate them, oh, gypsy, you know. And those poor people then have to do that. And of course, sometimes they take it of them, put it in jail, you know. And they sing their sorrow. And when they sing, then called carcelera, because was in jail, in carce, in Spanish, you know, carce. In this case, because they was in the carce, they sing the song, I am here and I don't do anything. En español, of course. Ay, estoy aquí, yo no he hecho nada. Porque quiero darle de comer a mis niños. Ay. And ahí came the song that came carcelera. Because igual, it's similar to the tonada, but some little elements different. Oh, you know, wow. And this is look at how is another one than called saeta. Saeta is what then called. The same thing is one tona, but in religious way. They dedicate all the week, is only in the, they sing a lot this in Easter week.
Oh, wow.
I don't know if you hear that. And you accompany with trumpet and drum. Of course, when we have a party and we don't have the trumpet and drum, the guitar do everything. Yes. And we have to learn how to do the trumpet and how to do the drum and everything to accompany. And this was the same thing, very nice. Dios mío, de mi alma te imploro. Everything we dedicate to religion, to Jesus, to the Virgin, and this is called saeta. And you know, and it's so many, it's four pieces like that. But in reality, it's called las tonas, son tonas, it's four different ones. From the tonas, is when one time somebody start to do sigirillas. And the sigirilla is when already then apply the guitar. Oh, another of the tona was what I say before, Martinete. Martinete was because the gypsy that worked in the blacksmith.
Oh, así, blacksmith.
Exacto, de ahí viene the word, martillo, Martinete. And de ahí viene this rhythm, because they accompany their section to work with the pam. Es el ritmo de sigirilla. Now, when you analyze this 3-4, 6-8 in music. 3-4, 6-8, but you do only the ascent. You see, the last two is the 6-8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, but you ascend only the ascent. You don't mark all, it's only the ascent. 2.
¿Qué progresión usas de maestro? ¿Qué progresión? ¿Qué acorde? ¿Cómo?
Normalmente es en A. O sea, es another thing that I talked with him many times, and it's so difficult this to understand and to explain, because obviously people don't want to know about play. In this case, when this hand by second say, Chimi Sigirilla, and I start to think, I say, okay, the best way is to teach him. And I teach him the rhythm and how to play. They don't know what's coming from, but of course, if you are going to write in paper, you have to be able to explain how it is and how divided the measurement, okay? In this case, 3, 4, 6, 8. But the difficulty is that you don't start in your first beat in number one, you start in number two. Confusing because you see, this is in when you play the guitar, and I can demonstrate you with the guitar. Yeah. Just the rhythm, then you have some idea. This is one of the more primitive flamenco songs now, besides the fourth basic, you know, the fourth basic, this is one of them, the first one.
No sé si esta guitarra le va a gustar, maestro.
No importa, es just to demonstrate the rhythm. Oh yeah, I will cut away. And now in Spain, they use many of the also yeah, called yeah, the yeah. Black. With the chair, you have to be careful. Okay, the rhythm. The rhythm is like only that. Just, for example, see? This is the rhythm. This is the rhythm. There, you can make it 100 or syncopation, of course. The rhythm, I mean, complicated, but you know, complicated when you teach it because when you teach somebody, say, okay, you got you do three times and now you ask at the flamenco, okay, why the rhythm? It is 3-2. What do you mean 3-2? Now I go,
that's say, how they talk, right?
Why 3-2? And you have to specify, say, okay, don't worry about just that you want 3-2, it's okay, but normally. Is this is 2-3-1. This is in 3-4, you see? 2, start in number 2 and
it's
one.
It's number 2.
2-3-1-2-3-4-5-6-1. You see 1 is the last one. In this case, it's complicated to explain, but to be right, if you see some of my Buddha and I have a rich in Grigia, it's like that, okay? In this case, this is one of the more, I mean, beautiful, you have many beautiful farsetta, complicated with rhythm, you have a melody. It's a beautiful farsetta in Sigirija, melodica, you know, and you can make it so beautiful thing. And this is the first one that apply guitar in the song, in Sigirija. This, oh, we need some accompany and some guitar play before, never. Later, after the Sigirija, come Soleares.
Soleare,
you know maybe, no? The or everybody tell it that.
Soleare es como una bulería lenta, maestro.
Exacto. Bueno, this is why bulería tirai from Soleare.
Se deriva, derived from, right?
Bulería dirai from Soleare. Soleare was fish. This is why I come to. But it's a lot, you know, and of course you have over there maybe help you to remember, but you know you forget everything. Soleare is a beautiful also, so many beautiful things. And you can make so many things with the rajeado, the melody. I mean, those are the rhythm that is also very complicated because you have the traditional rhythm is only that. The this is traditional. This is how you accompany song. Okay. And when the singer sing, they don't want that you do many fancy things because they lose inspiration. In this case, when they accompany, you already have to limit your rhythm traditional. This is. And they sing. Por Dios no me la vas a llevar, porque madre no hay más que una. You see, this is the song, and you keep only this kind of company. Of course, from there you have many variations. Sí. Because you see the con 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 1, 2, 3. You can start 1, 2, 3 and start in 3. You see, you can make it only the ascent, that means 3, 6, 8, 10, and 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You play only the ascent if you want. And you can make your those kind of variation, you know, the make it the down B silent, and then make it the up B. If, for example, Norma equals. Oh, you leave, you keep the dambi silent and pronounce only the api. And then it make it a syncopation. This is how you form syncopation. You see, those kind of things are important. Anyway, this was the second song that came in the bass. Exacto, country song, you can say, but the country song, en estida and play over here. You see the sigrilla, a little bit out to me. The other is here. Beautiful thing in Cervantes. This is derivation from the sigrilla.
Wow.
Even they believe that from the sigrilla, not the spiritual song, but the rhythms can also, what we call before the Colombiana, I mean the Colombiana, perdón, the Guajira.
The Guajira.
Believe so. And also Petenera. Petenera is a beautiful song. I don't know if you hear about
Nunca
Petenera.
Oh,
it's in my book. It's also a piece called Petenera. En Sueño. It's a beautiful, oh, gorgeous. Anyway, they believe the same because the same thing is 3-4-6-8. But the acento is reverse. Start in the 6-8 and it's that start in the 3-4. You know, like Guajira,
¿Cómo está esa? ¿Entre dos?
6, 8, 3, 4.
Ah, tú,
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4, but you see, it's the same rhythm of the sigrilla, but invert. And it's done 3-4-6-8, it's 6-8-3-4. Petenera is the same thing, and it's you know, a minor key. That's Petenera, but the same rhythm.
Guajira is in major, right?
Yeah, Guajira is in major.
¿Y la rondeña, maestro?
La rondeña es un tipo de taranta. This is what the mean when we talk about
so many.
You see when I say about the fandango, all those kind of things derive from the fandango. It's what we call three style.
Okay.
O sea, it's different rondeña. Igual rondeña la mía solo de guitarra del compositor Ramón Montoya, me divierte. Oh, ah, he called rondeña, because, you know, he was in ronda when he composed. Ronda is a scene, and he called rondeña. Rondeña is a type of fandango. You see, when I say fandango, fandango sí. Have many derivations. One is malagueña, you hear about malagueña.
Sí, claro.
Malagueña is from fandango. Taranta is from fandango. Ah, taranta, yeah. Malagueña, for example, is an E.
This is real.
Mi amor, estoy aquí reunido con el maestro de guitarra. Te puedo llamar en unos minutos, ya estoy terminando.
¿Viste que te quedaba? ¿Viste que me va?
It's nice.
Yo te llamo igual.
It's nice because, you know, you can amplify and the action is okay. That's really good.
No te preocupes, mi mamá. Pero mira, yo estoy terminando aquí, yo te llamo un momentito, ¿está bien? Chao. It was really bad, too.
Go there.
But those strings are old. 2 months there, man. I have to change.
What kind?
Dadario extra hard. Pro alto.
I used to endorse the Dadario for a long time.
Oh, really? What do you use?
Sometimes you use the Adario. I use it in normal tension.
Normal.
And sometimes I use the... For a long time I use la vela.
Uh-huh.
I endorse it. I still endorse la vela.
Oh, wow.
You see many packets. Then you sell with my teacher.
I
explained and it's good, extreme, blah, blah, blah. But I started to endorse la vela in the 60s, 1960.
Wow.
And later then separate. La vela was the song, the fire, the separate. And for a long time, I have a connection. Then, those are the songs and this, you know, Malagueña than here. Malagueña flamenca, I talk about. I mean, you do it till like that in Malagueña. Taranta normally is the same thing. Taranta, many people don't know that. If you put the K-pop in the second fret and play Malagueña, it's the same thing that you play Taranta, because Taranta will happen when you play here. This is the real Taranta. This is a beautiful taranto, you see? The difference here in me, here you play, and you okay. The thing how you play before, and you talk about before, siguirilla, or even bulería, traditional bulería, promedio. Promedio means en A. What happened that we call en A, like Malagueña, we call en E. This how the flamenco identify, because they don't know better. Centuries ago,
sure.
My father, when he teach me, you play an E, okay? But when you are going to write the music and paper, this is not an E, this is an A minor. You have to play an E.
Yeah, the key signature.
That's right.
The key signature. Music is A minor. In this one, when you play Siguirilla or Bulería, is an D minor. That's right, you understand that, no? But, of course, they say, is an A because you resort in it.
Exactly.
shock. And the people, flamenco people, they don't know better and say, play por medio, they even don't call it gay. This is por medio.
Por medio.
Because you use only half of the finger. And now this is por arriba, because you use the whole finger. That's a vocabulary.
Exactly.
You don't have to know about the training. If you drip,
no, that's important. Everything like that. Importante eso.
In this case, in Fandango, how you say the Fandango, the La Malagueña, no Malagueña Salerosa, that is from Mexico, or Malagueña by the Lecuona, that is
seguro,
from Cuba,
claro.
Lecuona, basic in the Hispanic flamenco malagueña, because he went to Malaga and he saw the rhythm of malagueña over there, like that. It's different, this is the popular. This is the Lecuona, this is different than one, you know, but I talk about the traditional, that is a lot for the traditional flamenco malagueña. This is in the key of E, and this coming from the Fandango. Also, rondeña, the La Taranta, in the same key and everything. It's another song. Rondeña means the song, it's not the play. You cannot say, play rondeña. Because rondeña, I can play over here. If I want, it's the same thing, how I say. It depends on your voice, I can play here. You know, and you can play the rondeña, you know. And it's a song. And this case, you have rondeña, you have malagueña, you have taranta, you have taranto, cartagenera, that is a people, murciana. All those times, it becomes coming the popular song of each of those cities. Murcia is a song,
Murcia.
Play in Spain. You know, the Cartagena is another play in Spain. Or this thing called ronda is another play in Spain. This is called rondeña, rondeña, murciana. And later, you have fandango, fandango de Huelva. Fandango de Arbolluyo, Fandango de Arcormao, Fandango de Albuquerque, Fandango de Villaverde. So you have 100 cities, each one have their own Fandango. The primical is almost the same, but all the songs are three. For example, when I mean three, if you... This is how we identify the song when I was a little. Nobody write music at the time. Say, how was the Soleare? I forget. How is Soleare? And they... When they don't say the melody, because it's no melody. The melody is one parcetta that you create yourself.
Uh-huh.
They sing the rhythm. And everybody says, oh, yeah, the Soleare. Tan, 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 ta, ta, tan, tarram, tarram. Because this is what you do. And this is how they identify. They identify by their rhythm.
The rhythms.
Now, they say, how is Sigirilla? Oh, yeah. Tram, ta ta tam 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 tam, que de. And this is how they say when she says, how is the Sigirilla? Tram, ta ta tam 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 tam, tram, tam, tram, ta ta tam. They sing, how is tango? Taram, ta tam 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 tam, taram, ta tam, taram, ta. They sing it the rhythm, they can sing it the melody, you know that? Day we apply a lot of melody because you have to play solo.
Uh-huh.
When you play concert, of course, you play tango, you have to have the melody. Because you combine the voice, the rhythm, and what you create. When at this time you accompany only the singer, and the singer, what you do is tango. Candelaria le pusieron Caruru, 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 caruru. This is a beauty for the accompany. You should just have the accent with the singing. But when they say sing the tango, the people want to say, right, taram, 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 taram. Only the rhythm. They don't pronounce melody. This is what happens now. Ma fandango, malagueña, taranto, rondeña, they don't have any definitive phrase like that dal Duke Valentine, che è ancora freestyle. The singer doesn't have to be limited in the rhythm, because you sing tango, you sing, you have to be unlimited.
Sì.
The song, the singer. Tierra del mundismo, you have to be entire. Candelaria le pusieron, carburu, si lo acento, va con el ritmo. She has to be the boy, has to be synchronized with the accompany. This is why accompany song is very difficult.
Wow.
The keys, they one sometime pronounce one phrase, make a long melisma. ¿Sabe lo que es la melisma?
No.
La melisma is the modulation of the voice. Sometimes you say, España, ay, 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 ay,
ay, ay, ay, ay, ay,
ay, ay, ay,
ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, ay, musical melisma.
Wow.
In this case, when you make it there, you know, in many... Nadie... Eso es libre, ¿eh? Please.
Sí.
Nadie en el mundo lo nombrará. Porque se encuentra caído cuando estuvo florecido. Eso es melisma, you see? You vas para arriba, vas para abajo y modula en el mismo. Eso es, se llama melisma. Entonces, cuando tú acompañas y the singer feel good, have a clear voice, he no, no drunk,
oh,
drinking, and this case he can make it long melisma. You have to be able to hear and know what he went to do. And order the same key, accompany. After that, you wait and you get the chord belong to the boy. And this is why it makes it difficult. You never know where we're going to start or what key he went to resort. Because he can create this case, your ear has to follow the key. And also have to follow the melisma, waiting longer, order longer, but you cannot do that. And waiting like that, you have to make it something fancy, but to follow with the voice.
And
soft, no loud, because if you cover his voice, the next time he will not hire you, and you don't have any money. In this case, this was why sometimes some people say, oh, why you don't hire Juan Serrano, because he accompanies so wonderful. You know, and the people hired me because I was good accompanist at this time,
course,
you know what I mean?
Course.
And this is why many, Paco de Lucía was a very good accompanist before I started solo.
Uh-huh.
He was a very good accompanist. Many others, no, but many others like me, you know, we start in this way, we start play accompanist, dance and so on, and later you change to be solo.
Wow.
And this case, those kind of things is the, what they call free song, because they don't have a phrase, then you can identify, like Soleare, as soon as you hear that, everybody says, oh, Soleare. Everybody knows. And if I do that, just that. Oh, Sigrilla. Everybody recognizes this. Now, you ask a Bulería. Bulería comes from Soleare. Caña, sometimes called La Caña, I don't know if you are familiar with it or you hear about this. La Caña, this comes from Soleare. El Polo comes from Soleare. Bulería. Cancro en Soleare.
La caña no lo he oído ni el otro polo tampoco.
Y the same thing is similar to the Soleare, but to have a one play that you have to do that and you have to be able to accompany with the song, the singer. You have to give the length of the eyes. You have to pronounce the same thing than the singer. Anyway, you see the door doors coming from the Soleare. You know,
Soleare.
And now you ask me for the Bulleria. This is the more complicated because it's incubation. You see, the rhythm is like the Soleare. 12 feet with the ascent of 3, 6, 8, 10, 12. You see? 1, 3, 6, 7, 8. But this is the more difficult.
No, man, sorry.
This is the more complex because the syncopation. Easy, for example, you make it the rhythm. You see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. It's syncopation that you make with anything, and the same thing, you can come over here and make it melody. Or these are syncopation, you see, and this is more complex than anyone. The letters falsetas son beautiful.
Falsetas,
sí. You see, and you make your other kind of falsetas that are so beautiful, so this, but this is the more exciting one. When you play Bulleria to anybody, this is a beautiful one. The rhythm is good. The rhythm is good. You do it. Because you keep it, your rhythm. You see, those chords is very nice. You can make some simple falsetta sometimes.
Yeah.
And let me make the scale, of course. You can make it, and the people say, how you do it so easy? And because you pronounce only the accent. You see, you are all in 12. 12. 10. You see what I mean? And this, when you do that, you come and say, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You see what I mean? And now you can make a melody. 15. This is what makes it so difficult, the Bulleria, but another time we continue. Continue.
Yeah, we can do it again, right? We can do part two. Part two.
Yeah, yeah.
Let us learn double that idea.
Tremendo,
before,
maestro.
Before learning the idea of the technique, I have to go.
No se vaya.